Erica, talk about these online support groups. I mean, you're an attorney, Dr. Murphy's a physician, and both of you have found these online support groups, which, by the way, says a lot about where we are as far as our knowledge of the virus and the consequences. We're not that very far, because even highly functioning, highly resourced people are still turning online to find support groups.
Absolutely. And, you know, for me, it's been like a lifeline. And I know that I am actually, I'm very lucky in a lot of ways in that I have a great support system. I have doctors that believe me when I'm telling them that there's something weird and something wrong, friends that are supportive, family that's supportive, a job that is letting me leave and still holding my place for me for at least a little bit. But for a lot of people in these online support groups, that's not the case. Mm. They don't have support. They have doctors that are looking at them and wondering if it's all just in their head and, you know, dismissive family, dismissive work environment. So having somewhere where we can go and vent and also share our symptoms and compare and contrast and not feel crazy and feeling like, you know, our hand doesn't belong to ourselves or we really are confused and this really is happening. It's not just in our head. And also talking about what's worked for us and what hasn't worked for us has been invaluable for me.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Dr. Murphy, before we go, I want to ask you, what do you think is actually causing the brain fog? What is happening physiologically or pathophysiologically as why people are experiencing this?
There is infection, actually, of brain cells by SARS-CoV-2. And then the blood, small blood vessels actually reorient in ways that are not their natural pattern. Mm-hmm. And that may account for some of the symptoms that we're having. And then hypoxia in general, which is something that happens with COVID, right? Because it is often with respiratory manifestations where you don't have enough oxygen, right? The way that impacts the brain is that, very preferentially, there are some parts of the brain that are impacted more than others.
Sure.
The hippocampus, which is involved in short-term memory or working memory, is heavily impacted by hypoxia. So I think that that's probably some of what's happening, the explanation for what's happening here.
Sure. Well, you know, more research needs to be done, obviously. This is a problem for a lot of people. So Erica, we want to thank you for joining us and sharing your story. You too, Dr. Murphy. And Erica, you know what? We're going to get you in to see a neurologist. We know it's hard to get to see a neurologist. We have a little bit of a sway here at the doctors, so we're going to get you to see one, okay?
Oh, thank you so much.
Okay. Take care, guys.